You've got boyfriends, girlfriend, you're not married, but your unfaithful sin becomes Amen. Part of you. Today, when you are coming forward,
a little mobile,
you know where things are wrong.
What's he already been persuaded fit a guy?
Unfaithfulness. God loves you as you are coming. You are here for yourself, remember. That unfaithfulness will be checked in you. That
faithfulness will be checked in you.
Before God, there's no pastor. There's no prophet. There's no apostle. All children of God. With assignments.
Amen.
With assignments. So take a decision today.
Let's lift our two hands. And you are going to pray after me. Say after me, Holy Father God, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. I have heard your word. Father, you know where I am not faithful. Today, I repent of my unfaithfulness. I believe in my heart that you raised Jesus Christ from death. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior of my life. Thank you, Holy Father God, for helping me to be faithful. Thank you, Holy Father God, for making me your child. I'm born again. I'm a child of God. Unfaithfulness has passed away. Faithfulness has come to my life. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Yes. Very good. I want to tell you that coming here, when you are praying the prayer you have prayed, it's not final. Because those things that devil knows, using them to catch you with. You know, already you say you have left them here. So Satan is still going to come.
Satan
and check if you have followed them here.
He
is as good as Satan enter you by anger. When you were praying that prayer here, you left your anger there. So now things will happen to test. Are you sure you left your anger there or is still in you? So when you say, no, I've left it there. You left it by faithfulness. You will deny to do what you were doing before. You will deny to say, you have to be angry. Or Satan will enter you. You have a boyfriend or your
girlfriend.
After here, your boyfriend or your girlfriend will call you.
Oh, love, boyfriend, girlfriend, ta phone.
Hey, where are you?
Oh, kokai.
Come tonight.
Itali home.
If you are going there, it means you didn't do anything here.
I was somewhere like a rara wadi asilo.
You know, my friend, I grew up with one of my friends. He told me something. He's a pastor of
Faith Mission.
He told me something that he was many years when we are doing this thing of pastoring.
So
he told me that in his church, if you commit sin, you are not baptized. It means you were bathing the day he baptized you. So he said, I've already baptized people 30 times. Because here you were swimming. So now, It must mean a lot for you to come here.
Isuncho volela tava ichula utilemo.
I'm sure you hear it.
Katemana liangua.
You know, altar is where you meet with God.
Alitare inkimo kopana limudim.
If you are coming here.
Awitamo.
Because you are stealing.
Kaovano ya utwa.
I'll tell you this, this is a serious test, I'm telling you.
Kitiko is serious.
The moment when you are saying, God,
yes, enter my heart.
When you tell like this,
the day when you
are going home, you'll be
surprised.
Someone's money is here.
And you are
behind.
And when I was shaking camera.
Before you could not wait when it goes down, you just. But this person is going maybe somewhere there. You were supposed to go there. You follow. You know you are not going there. But you are going there because you want this money to go down. When the money goes out and fall down, you stand on top of it. Have you ever found people standing on top of something? Take out the phone, they do like this.
Ancha phone ukarwa bolela.
Person is going. And now you make like the phone is falling down.
Wadro karo phone yela yawa.
You are carrying on.
Watsala pele wachachiletela.
And the moment you do it now once.
Kana kwe ukatirati.
You will do it double now.
Utlo itira hape hape.
Because the Bible says even the demons left you.
They
search for the strong ones, they come. If they
find
Jesus is not in you,
the
Bible says the situation will be worse than before. This time you will be going around trying to steal everywhere until they catch you, beat you up. I don't know if you're
hearing
what I'm
saying.
So when you come here, don't play with the altar. Make sure you are repenting. But you will be challenged. If you challenge, confess at the same time. If a brother say hello, come use the window. Come and use the on the weekend you will use the, that other one.
Weekend
don't use that other one. But now I'm saved. I can't use windows.
Brother,
you don't want to be saved too.
Me,
Christian, with Jesus using windows. Think about you've got Jesus in you. Past 11. You are climbing the window. With Jesus, you are entering through the window. With Jesus, you don't know where is the door. I mean, there are things that, you know, will tell you that Satan is still in you. Confess these things. Brother, go. If
it's possible, get out of the car, church, and go in
and
phone.
Say, brother, you know, in my relationship, I believe in marriage. And now I've accepted
Jesus.
But if brother is giving you grocery,
mara avuta ofa grocery.
Uferile, uno wana fish fela uferile.
You are finished. When you see fish, you are finished.
If brother is giving you grocery and you
avuta ofa grocery yela.
Uburoto bula usneri slice bula.
Bread without slices.
Uno tali onari bona bona. Babona lofui.
And he brings it to you see it. And you saw smoke
name.
Coming out.
Jesus, tell, don't
and
pray.
You say in Jesus' name,
brother,
don't give me your loaf of bread.
If you want to marry me, do it right. I don't know if you hear me. I don't know if you're going to do that. Lift up your heads. Lift up your heads. Yeah, God bless you. Clap hands for yourself. If we do that, you know what will happen? Can I tell you? When you are asleep, you begin to see those people who were coming to you in the night. Eat up your flesh. You begin to say, in the name of Jesus, they will run away. Right now, they are able to come in the night and do what they are doing on you. And they say, open your mouth. They say, close your mouth. And then from there, they say, open your mouth. They block finances, they block everything. They make you to lose your job. Today I'm going to pray for you.
Amen.
I want you to surrender to God.
Amen.
Listen to this. Sin will always be sin.
Even
some people, like parents, they are even afraid to tell you that this is
wrong.
You cannot be reprimanded. But listen to this. I'm telling you as a parent.
Sin
is sin. If you are failing to overcome it now, it will block you there. It's a weapon of Satan to cage you. You will never pray, God hear your prayer.
It's
your prayer becomes abomination. I'm very happy for you who have accepted Jesus.
Amen.
Be ready for Jesus and serve him in the house of God. God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you. We have pastors.